What is up, everybody? So, as you may know, I'm probably the best gamer that I know. Like, I balled out on everybody on 2K and Halo 3 and Halo 1 and even the original Mario. Like, I have the world record and I'm not even joking. But the PlayStation 2 is one of those consoles that I've never owned, and I'm kind of salty about that I never owned it because I had the PlayStation 1, I had the first one, and that thing completely changed my life. I literally became vegan and all that stuff. So I'm kind of wondering if I owned the PlayStation 2 when I was younger, like would my religion change and stuff like that. Now, starting off, there were a couple different variants of the PlayStation 2. And I just want to say, guys, like all these puns and stuff that I come up with are on top of my head. Like I don't even have this stuff in my script. Isn't that crazy? But there were a couple variants of the PlayStation 2 that came out. This is actually the first one, and this is the original one. And the second one was a lot smaller than this. They called it the Slim, I believe, the PlayStation 2 Slim. And that actually came in a white color as well, which is super crazy. I kind of low-key wish I had that, but it's really not the end of the world, you know? I definitely like the Slim version more. And I don't know why, but the Slim version is still kind of expensive on eBay. Maybe it's a collector's item, I'm not too sure. But just know that if you're planning on getting one of these, just know the Slim version is a lot more expensive. And the PlayStation 2 actually came out in 2000, which was over 18 years ago. So some of you guys watching this video might actually be younger than this gaming console. So make sure y'all show some respect to it. It's older, respect your elders and all that good stuff. Now, believe it or not, I didn't actually know this, but this actually got discontinued in 2012. And I literally, like, I didn't know it had that long of a lifespan. I thought it got discontinued in like 2004 or 2006 or something. So that's super crazy. I mean, just to think that this thing had such a long lifespan. And maybe that's including the updates that this thing got, because this thing did support the internet connectivity and all that stuff, which I will get into in a second, but that's super crazy to think. Now, I'm just gonna get this out of the way, and it's kind of embarrassing. I'm kind of an idiot, but when I went to film this video, something bad actually happened, which kind of destroyed my life. I'm gonna show you right now, and I don't even know what I'm showing on the screen, but pretty much before I film something, I usually just put my hand in and kind of get the screen. Because I got a new camera and it autofocus and all that stuff, and pretty much when I went to do this and I went to hold it up, I actually ended up dropping the PlayStation 2, and it ended up breaking it. I don't know what exactly what happened to it, because when I tried to plug it in again and try to connect to the ports, it wasn't booting up, and I was kind of sad for a second, but I really only spent like $20-something on it, so it's really not the end of the world. I mean, I'll get gameplay some other way. I'll just download an emulator or something, but it is kind of sad that I'm not able to experience that fully through a game, but it's okay. I think I'll get over it. But so body wise, I mean, this thing definitely seems dated a bit. I'm not going to lie. It doesn't look ugly though. The PlayStation 1 looks pretty ugly. This still actually looks fairly up to date. There's two USB ports up front. The CD drive and memory cards are up front as well as controller inputs underneath it. Now the power input is on the back and a master power switch as well. Now one thing that really stood out to me was the controller, which was pretty much the same as the PlayStation 1s, but this thing actually had the option of being wireless. They were very, very expensive at the time, which I remember because I used to go to Walmart to get the PlayStation 1 controllers. I don't really remember if they were backwards compatible or not, but I mean, I think it's groundbreaking in my eyes that, you know, especially me, someone, I hate wires. I switched to Bluetooth everything even. So this changed my outlook on everything at the time. Now, upon further investigation, I actually read that the PlayStation 2 was being planned out around the same time that the original PlayStation was released, which kind of makes me sad because if I knew that at the time, I would be so mad about, because the PlayStation 2 was far better than the PlayStation 1. And it's not like an incremental improvement. So if I knew that they were already rendering out the designs and everything of the PlayStation 2 when they just released the PlayStation 1, I'd be kind of salty about, but this was eons ago, so I really had no say in it. Now, the game selection for this thing is something I always talk about with every console that I review, and this thing is very, very good as well. I wouldn't say it's up to par with Nintendo's, especially with like the Nintendo Wii and DS, somewhere in that realm, but really those came out after, so there's really no point in even bringing those up. But the game selection for this thing was good. This console brought Grand Theft Auto, San Andreas, Final Fantasy, Jack and Dexter, and so many more games, including some new Spyro the Dragon games and Crash Bandicoot games, which I freaking love. Those two games, or those two like sets of games, I freaking love those games. I could play those every single night, every single day. I don't know, that's pretty much just, I don't want to get too emotional about it, but man, Spyro and Crash or something that I just freaking, like if Spyro the Dragon and Crash Bandicoot were like charities or something, I would probably donate all my money just because they like morphed me into who I am today. I'm done being emotional. Like, I get too emotional with these videos and I go on a rant. Now, like I said, I couldn't get the PlayStation 2 to work, so I played Spyro's A Hero Tale on an emulator, which is also a PlayStation 2 game, and I actually like this game a lot. I don't think it's better or even on par with the earlier, like Spyro 1, 2, and 3, but it's definitely okay. Crash Bandicoot, all those games work perfectly fine if your console works fine. But one thing I don't really like now when I look at it are the CD drives, but I do understand that, you know, that was an incremental time. Now everything's gone digital, but at the time everything was CD and that was kind of the new trend. So yeah, that's pretty much where I'm gonna leave it at. And graphics were actually very good as well. Overall gameplay was very good, and in my opinion, this has to be one of the greatest gaming consoles of all time. If you don't believe me, fight me. But especially considering the rivalry between the GameCube, Xbox, and PlayStation 2, I can't think of another rivalry, if I'm saying that right, of gaming consoles. I mean, the only ones I can think of are the Nintendo Wii, 360, and PlayStation 3, but I think that's just like the sibling rivalry of the GameCube, Xbox, and PlayStation 2, because even I, the person who only had a PlayStation 1, still knew and heard about it, even before I had like internet access and I went on like AOL.com and stuff like that, and I would hear like the dial-up ringtone and stuff, I would even still hear about it then, that, oh my god, do you have a GameCube, Xbox, or PlayStation? Oh my god, PlayStation versus Microsoft. I think people said PlayStation versus Microsoft at the time. They didn't really say PlayStation versus Xbox. I don't really know why, but yeah, and at the time, GameCube was pretty much considered like the underdog, because that was kind of more so for kids, and the Xbox and PlayStation were things where people could play like Call of Duty, and they could play against each other since they had internet connectivity. So yeah, I mean, it's definitely an interesting thing. I mean, it's super cool that it even had internet connectivity, so you could actually play certain games over the internet using a PlayStation 2 network adapter. Now, the funny thing is with that was that you actually had to rely on third-party servers hosting those games. So if their server crashed, then, you know, you were pretty much out of luck, because of all those games that PlayStation made, they didn't have, I guess, on-site servers at the time. So they had to rely on other servers. So if you were playing a game on, let's just say you're playing Call of Duty, the game that you were playing against your friends here might not be the same experience as if you were playing on Halo. I know Halo is not a Microsoft or Sony game, but you could have a different experience playing another game versus another game online, which is kind of makes sense if you think about it. But if you imagine now, like all the servers will go down and nobody could play online, but back then some servers could go out and some people could still play other games online, which honestly in theory kind of sounds pretty cool. I mean, I don't want to be too reliant on it, but yeah, whatever. So to end it off, the PlayStation 2 was a super, super interesting gaming console. It brought a lot, you know, and one thing I really like about it was that it didn't really have too many problems. You know, we know with like Xbox 360 and PlayStation 3, they had the red light and yellow light of death. Even the Nintendo Wii had not so many, but a couple problems. I think the Nintendo Wii honestly didn't even have any problems now that I think about it, but I'm sure it did. But yeah, I mean, the PlayStation 2 was definitely a W for Sony's career. If you're planning on picking one up, I would say 100% go for it. There's really no reason not to get it. This video is going to be so long because I went on so many tangents, but I wouldn't really get this for a, you know, gaming standpoint. I mean, yeah, if you find one in pretty good condition, go for it. I don't know if these things were really easy to break or not, because I only dropped my thing like a couple feet and it crashed it and it doesn't turn on anymore. And actually, I don't know if I already said this, but actually when I shake it, there's like bits and pieces in it that are like shaking around. So yeah, I would definitely get it for like a collector's item standpoint, but to actually play and stuff like that, I would probably just end up getting a PlayStation 3. Because even that is like pretty cheap nowadays. I'll actually try to review one. If you guys want to see a video of me reviewing a PlayStation 3 or a Nintendo GameCube, I actually already have one. If you guys want to see those videos, definitely hit that like button so I know. But yeah, with like PlayStation 3, it's backwards compatible, so you can actually go and play those games. You can even play PlayStation 1 games, I believe. But I don't remember if Sony has actually disabled the market for PlayStation, the PlayStation Network for Sony PlayStation 3. So I would definitely go and check that, because I mean, PlayStation 1 games are still super sick. PlayStation 2 games are much better. They have much better graphics than the PlayStation 1 games. And there's a much bigger variety there too. But you know, they're not making any more games for the PlayStation 2. So you're pretty much stuck in terms of game selection, but thankfully it's not a bad game selection at all. And I would highly, highly recommend you guys to get one just for a collector standpoint. But if you want to actually play the games, consider getting a PlayStation 3, guys. And that is pretty much it. If you guys have any questions or anything like that, definitely feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below. Hit that like button. Like I said, if you want to see the PlayStation 3 video or a Nintendo GameCube video or any other video you guys want to see, definitely leave a comment in the comment section below so that I can go and, you know, go see what you guys want. But definitely hit that like button, like I said. Hit that subscribe button as well. We are still doing the iPhone 6s and iPhone SE giveaway on this channel. And in order to enter, all you have to do is subscribe to the channel and follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Both those links are down in the description, so you make sure you guys enter that. I don't want to go like 3 weeks from now because I'm probably going to be picking the winner about a month from now. Guys, just go ahead, follow me, everything, subscribe so you guys are entered and we'll be all good. There's a link in the description too so you guys can enter there. But more importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys and hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.